This Hausdorff simulation is an example of game theory. Game theory became more known through John Nash, who was portrayed in the movie A Beautiful Mind, and his role was played by Russell Crowe. I won't explain much about it, except that I am using a mixed evolutionary strategy, and this is explained here, and I did that on the next sheet. We need a few assumptions. What are the benefits and the cost to gain, to lose, for injury, and the cost for injury? And then we are giving the confrontations between a hawk and a hawk, 50% win, 50% chance, hawk and a dove, etc. Based on those assumptions, we are going to calculate here what the hawk-hawk costs and benefits are. And this is the formula we used in there for hawk-hawk. Then hawk-dove. Then dove-hawk. And dove-dove. Based on that information, we make a table that says what is the frequency of each one. So for the hawk, that is going to be this formula that we copy down. And for the dove, it is that formula that we can copy down. And then we plot the results in this chart. And you will see that we reach a stability at this point, which is basically at almost 0.6 frequency. If we change anything in there, that will affect, of course, where the stable strategy is. So let's calculate the slope of the hawk situation. So we use the slope function. Based on B2 through B10 for the y's, and the axis is A2 through A10. And for the dove, that is a similar situation, of course. Okay. And then we calculate the intercept. So the slope determines what the inclination is of each curve. The intercept is where the starting point is, where it crosses the y-axis. And the intercept is done with the intercept function. Okay. Then where do we intersect on the x-axis? That is calculated according to this formula. The intercept, I called that 2. So the intercept 2 is this intercept minus intercept 1 divided by slope 1 minus slope 2. And the intercept y is slope 1 times intercept x, this one, plus the intercept for 1. So that is how we find what the intersects are. So if I change something, if I say, for instance, that the gain is not 50, but 60, then the curves will automatically adjust, of course. And then the intersect is 0.67. That's where the stable strategy kicks in. I'm going to undo that. For instead of changing it manually, I'm going to set the gains with a data table or a data table, and I did that here. So I say if the gain is 10 or 20 or 30 or 40, where would the x-intercept be? So we recalculate everything based on the intersect that we have now, this one. So we put in here equals B16, that is this guy, So that means when we run this thing for different gains, it's going to run this calculation based on all the previous calculations. And we do that with a data table. And for the data table, we are going to say that we want that to be based on J2. That is this one. So you select this range. Make sure that you have a reference or a link there to the intersect X. These are manual inputs. And then we create a data table. Data, what-if analysis, data table, which is a very powerful tool in Excel. No row input, because we use that function there. But the column input is based on 10, 20, 30, 40, so that's based on that cell, for that is the cell that is being used in all the calculations. J2. And when we accept that, it puts that formula in there. So, and it will automatically change everything for different gains. Of course, you could do a similar table for the lose factor. You would do something similar, down here or wherever you want it. But this time you would put the lose factors in here. So in the data table, you would make a link not to J2, but to J3, etc. And you could do the same for injury. And of course, I don't have to tell you that, you could also change the win and chance situations. The end result is that we will always have a curve that tells us where the game theory predicts that the stable strategy will kick in. Partially thanks to John Nash, the Nobel laureate, in the movie A Beautiful Mind.